Strategic bombers like the Boeing B-52 Stratofortress were built to fly over enemy territory and hit targets with large bombs or nuclear weapons. One of these heavily armed bombers can wipe out an entire city. The problem with bombers is they can be seen and intercepted by enemy jet fighters. But imagine for a moment a country with a bomber completely invisible to radar and able to deliver a crippling airstrike before anyone knew what happened. The very first stealth bomber in the world, the US Air Force's B-2 Spirit bomber, first took flight in 1989. With more than 30 years of service, this heavy strategic stealth bomber is capable of dropping up to 80 500-pound class MK-82 JDAM GPS-guided bombs or 16 2,400-pound B-83 nuclear bombs. The B-2 Spirit's range is estimated at over 6,900 miles on internal fuel and over 11,900 miles with one mid-air fueling. Because these aircraft had significantly higher costs to produce than what was estimated, there were only 20 B-2 Spirit bombers built out of the 130 that were originally planned. Each B-2 Spirit bomber had an initial cost of $737 million in 1997. But the overall program cost, including maintenance, equipment, retrofitting, and software support, ran the total up to a current $2.1 billion each. Currently, at the time of this video, there are 21 B-2 Spirit bombers operating and conducting missions. And just recently, B-2 stealth bomber aircraft from the 509th Bomb Wing and the 131st Bomb Wing were deployed to Europe from Whiteman Air Force Base in Missouri. As amazing as this aircraft is, there's another that is already being designed and built that will take its place, the B-21 Raider. Development of the B-21 Raider began in 2015, and the first aircraft is expected to take flight in early 2022. Many of its features are highly classified, but what's certain is that it will be the future of stealth bomb technology. Armed with the latest in highly advanced radar technology and incredibly powerful and destructive weapons. The B-21 Raider is a long-range, heavy payload stealth intercontinental strategic bomber able to deliver conventional and thermonuclear weapons to its targets. The B-21 Raider is improved with two generations of stealth technology versus the B-2 Spirit, making it even more undetectable than its predecessor. It'll be a highly survivable aircraft and the US Air Force's central part of a penetrating joint team. The new B-21 stealth bomber is smaller than the B-2 Spirit, with a wingspan of around 150 feet. This bomber will likely be manned. However, there'll be an option for this aircraft to operate unmanned. And some military officials think that its first fight should be without pilots. The Pentagon plans to procure at least 100 B-21 Raiders for about $654 million per bomber. But the Pentagon would like another 100 or more B-21 Raiders in service to replace both the B-1 Lancers and the B-2 Spirits, as these aircraft have become outdated. One mention-worthy US stealth naval bomber is the A-12 Avenger II. This small, subsonic stealth bomber had a range of 1,000 miles and a payload capability of 5,160 pounds, including two AIM-120 AMRAAM air-to-air missiles, two AGM-88 HARM air-to-ground missiles, and unguided or precision-guided bombs. Even though the A-12 Avenger II program was eventually cancelled in 1991 due to cost overruns and several delays, the technology it was carrying and its design were truly futuristic. It would seem that the United States military has cornered the market when it comes to stealth bombers. But on the other side of the Atlantic, Russia has been developing its own futuristic stealth bomber, the PAK-DA. It'll have an operational range of about 7,500 miles and the capability to continuously stay in the air for up to 30 hours with refueling. The PAK-DA will be able to drop a 30-ton payload, including air-to-surface and air-to-air missiles and conventional and smart-guided bombs. It'll also probably carry the KH-32 cruise missile, which is currently under development, and is Russia's latest anti-ship missile specifically designed to attack US carrier strike groups. The first three prototype bombers are slated to be handed over to the Russian Air Force by 2023, with plans for mass production by 2027. The projected cost per bomber is approximately $160 million, much lower than the US counterparts. But the Russian Air Force didn't stop there. they're also modernizing their existing fleet of supersonic Tu-160 bombers. The new Tu-160M2 will be a heavily upgraded version of its predecessor, featuring a stealth, low observable coating. This model will be equipped with the new Kuznetsov NK-32, which is an afterburning 3-spool low bypass turbofan jet engine able to deliver 55,000 pound-feet of thrust, giving it a greater operational range and control systems, as well as improved thrust and underfueled range. It'll also have a new defense system protecting it from missiles. The Tu-160M2's primary weapon will continue to be the long-range, air-launched, conventional KH-101 missiles or KH-102 cruise missiles that can carry a nuclear warhead. The Russian Air Force signed an order for 10 Tu-160M2s, with delivery expected in 2023. However, they plan to acquire at least 50 Tu-160M2 bombers in total, and to revamp all existing 17 Tu-160s according to the M2 standards. We've seen what the United States and Russia has in store with their stealth bomber plans for the future, but lately everyone's eyes are on China. And not surprisingly, right this moment, China is also developing a new, nearly undetectable stealth bomber, the Xi'an H-20. The H-20 will be exclusively produced in China, and it'll take the place of the current Xi'an H-6 jet bomber. From announcements in the Chinese media, it's said that it will follow the flying wing design, which interestingly enough, looks just like the United States Air Force's B-2 Spirit. However, the final design has not yet been officially presented. And even though the precise specifications of the Xi'an H-20 are confidential, it's expected to have an unrefueled range of at least 7,500 miles, giving it the ability to strike targets as far as the second island chain, an area stretching from the Kurils in the north through Japan, the Bonins, the Marianas, the Carolines, and Indonesia in the south. Some analysts argue, though, that the H-20's primary purpose would be to inflict damage to US aircraft carrier strike groups. Most probably, it'll be able to drop 20 tons of payload, including both conventional and nuclear armament. Chinese military experts expect the H-20 to have a superior stealth defense capability and performance that would rival the US Air Force's B-2 Spirit. The PLAF, People's Liberation Army Air Force, plans to have the Xi'an H-20 as part of their fleet by 2025. Many analysts, however, are quite skeptical over China's aeronautical abilities to produce a modern long-range strike bomber that would be comparable to the US aircraft, especially when it comes to engines. Historically, China had a bumpy ride trying to develop a successor to their Xi'an H-6 twin-engine jet bomber in the 1980s. Their aspiration to improve the H-6's fuel efficiency, range, and payload capacity bred the Xi'an H-8. According to the 1980s prototype specifications, it could carry conventional weapons, air-to-ground missiles, nuclear bombs, and other weapons, and it had a range of 5,000 miles. Also, it could be operated at night under complex climate conditions. The H-8's layout idea was simple. By basing it on H-6's hull and design, they would increase the number of underwing turbofan engines from 2 to 4. Almost 10 years and several unfruitful attempts later, the H-8 project was cancelled. China's interest in large strategic bombers stopped in the 1980s, and other projects were prioritized at the time. However, China attempted again in 1994 to develop the H-8 in order to have a stealth bomber that would be comparable to the American ones. With an ability to drop a payload of 18 tons, the H-8 can travel at 1.2 Mach and penetrate defended territory or in order to escape. Its first flight was in 2008. The farthest unrefueled range of the Chinese aircraft is over 6,900 miles, and its armament includes 12 Redbird 3 cruise missiles distributed on 2 rotating weapons pylons, each with a portable nuclear warhead and a range of 1,900 miles. The H-8 can also carry satellite-guided bombs and anti-ship missiles and other weapons. However, the Chinese aircraft are approximately 20 to 25 years technologically behind the US in 2008 standards. Similar specifications are seen in the B-2 Spirit, which was developed almost 20 years before the H-8. We could easily analyze the skepticism over the Chinese aeronautical history over multiple episodes, but the question everyone must be asking is, how is the Xi'an H-20 going to compare to the highly sophisticated B-21 Raider, or even the upgraded Russian PAK-DA? Only the future will tell us. The one thing we can be certain of is that the US, Russia, and China are all moving towards modernized stealth bombers that can spread major havoc on their targets without being detected by enemy radar. So, now that you've seen some of the most advanced stealth bombers in the world, which one do you think is best? Let us know, and if you enjoyed the video, give us a like, share, and subscribe to be the first to know when a new video arrives. Thanks for watching.